took you, baby. I just wanna take a little time out to thank you, baby. Thank you for your love. You came along and showed me that a man can't live by bread alone. And you came along and taught me that no, I just can't make it on my own.
What's going on, everybody? It's your man, Sabir Bay, sitting here with Louis and Narcisse with the beautiful models. We just got them doing a photo shoot, you know what I mean? Now we're ready to get down to business with the man, you know what I mean? Pharaonicorp brand. All right, so brother, Lou.
So,
finally get to meet you, bro, even though we knew each other for years. But the world may not know who you are, man. Tell us a little bit about the brand, man, and why you start, you know, the brand out.
I've been in the fashion industry for almost 20 years, and started in college, but I got serious about it when I started working in the fashion industry. And working in the industry for so long, you get exposed to a lot of different designs, a lot of trends and stuff like that. So, you know, after a while, you know, after seeing, my eyes were open as to how to make this stuff and how the stuff made and how a lot of designs come about, you know, I felt there was something lacking in terms of who I was, you know what I'm saying, what represented me. So I just had the idea of coming up with my own line, and it really wasn't a question as to what it was going to be, because I've been into ancient Egypt designs and artwork and architecture ever since I was a little kid. So I felt it was a perfect way for me to just tie in my two passions for the history of Africa and to tie it into fashion, because, you know, a lot of people don't know on the design end, there's a lot of us in the fashion industry that don't get exposed the way we should. I mean, all the Ralph Lauren's, Polo, we have a lot of designers behind the scenes, but, you know, they don't get any time to shine because, you know, they're working for a brand already, so none of them really get to break out and do their own thing. So,
really, what makes your brand different than Puffy's? Because you said over 20 years, man. What's the difference, man? You should have been out there, man, on that runway, man. Like,
Puffy, you know, he's got a lot of financial backing behind him. You know, I'm not trying to get rich with this. I just really want something to represent us.
You want to pass. So, you want to pass it down.
Yeah, I want to pass it down. So, you know, what makes my stuff different is that I focus on ancient symbology. I utilize the symbols that our ancestors left behind for us, because I feel it was left behind for us to empower us, you know what I'm saying? Once you embrace it in the right way, it empowers you and you know, in
images.
The images. So yeah. The brand has been around for about 5 years. I rebranded it about I rebranded it about 2 years ago. I was focused on promotions and just getting the brand image before I started putting it back out there. So, you know, the feedback that I've been getting is that, you know, from anyone that knows me and knows the line, that it's really empowering. It feels really like, you know, it uplifts.
I mean, they belong.
Yeah, it uplifts you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because that's what the symbols were left for us to do, is to uplift us and to give us a better sense of who we are, instead of a brand that doesn't really care anything about you, telling you, you know, giving you what they think you should be, what image you should portray. So I'm really, really focus on the brand representing us as a people. And and you know, people always ask me, like, is it just a black thing? It really isn't just a black thing. It's just that we can relate to it because it's our people that was putting it out there. So, you know, I don't ever stop anyone else from buying my product, but at the end of the day, we are the ones that can relate mostly to it, because, you know, those are our symbols, and we should be the ones utilizing it to the best of our abilities.
Sean Carter, Puffy, y'all better watch out for this, man. Hey, look, how do you pick your models, man?
Can
we get an introduction to who they are?
You can actually say this is like a family business, man, because everyone here is like family to me. I work very closely with them. Some of these people here I've known for 20 years, some people I've known for 5 years, some people for two. But, you know, when you work in terms of vibrations, when you're doing something that someone's vibing with you on, it don't matter how long you know them, you guys, once you hit that certain vibration, you're working on that level, no matter how long you know them, you're on that level, and that you know that you can run with them, and you just make a go for them, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, listen, Let's see how good you are. Name your models,
man. That's my man, Quico. This is my homegirl, Monique. My boy, Paul. You guys want to have a blue pill?
Yes, sir.
This is my homegirl, Anna. This is Rochelle. This is Tiana right here. My man, Ira. My boy, Jamal.
Her Anna's the stylist.
Yes, yes. She's Diva Dreams. This is actually another one of my... people that I collab with, Diva Dream Collections. She has her own makeup line, and you want to talk about it real quick?
Well, everybody, this is Anna Smith, the CEO and creator of Diva Dreams Collections. If you want to know more about me, you can hit up the website, www.divadreamscollection.com.
We got a lot of talent in this room, man. So where do you want to see this go, man? Where do you want to see this
thing?
You
know, it's crazy because it's 2011 now, and I call it the double helix year, you know. It's a really powerful year in terms, you know, for people who really know about the power of the 11. I'm a massive number 11, so I got to run with it this year. I've been working with this brand. I rebranded it for a couple of years now, and 2010 was a really good year in terms of getting exposure. I had some people hitting me up, some people in the entertainment industry hitting me up that want to work with me. So, you know, that's why I'm pushing it real hard right now, because I feel as a culture, we really need this, man. There really isn't anything out there representing. Yes. There's not too much out there representing who we are, you know what I'm saying? And especially on a larger scale. I work in the fashion industry, so I see a lot of designers crash and burn. Not saying that I have, you know, I'd like to be here like in another 10 years with my own shops, like Mark Echo and anyone else that can open up a shop. But at the same token, too, on the consumer side, I really want people to start, you know, focusing on who's representing them instead of, you know, going out to the stores and spending their dollars and, you know, anything that doesn't really represent them. You know, not even necessarily me. Yeah. I'm saying, you know, we got people.
Why not?
It won't hurt, but I'm saying, like, I'm out here trying to do something for the people, and even if they don't buy it, we'll do it regardless, because it's a labor of love. So,
and getting back to greatness.
Getting back to greatness. You know, it don't matter if anybody buys it, but I'm just saying that I'm not here for you guys, trying to get everyone to get back to greatness and to elevate us, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you heard it firsthand, brother. Congrats. It's going to work out, man. Man Sabir signing off. Check us out, Facebook, YouTube us. We're going.
All right, the website too. Let me give you the website real quick. It's www.pharaonicdesigns.com. And that's Pharaonic, PharaonicDesigns, Designs, DesignsI.com.
I want to thank all of the models. This is
thank you guys. Thank you guys. Round of applause to you guys.
Thank you, baby. Just wanna take a little time out.
Optimum cable commercial.
We taking
prison
pictures. Now we're trying to out. You know what I'm saying?
Hold up. The two shortest in the front and the three tallest behind.
Right. But I mean, we don't want to do 42nd Street closes.
What's wrong with 42nd Street, man? What's wrong with y'all, man? Don't
Feds Magazine, baby. Feds Magazine.
That's right. Yes.
Excited?
Ah, that's a great picture. Oh.